Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Heroes, Song of the Ocean Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. I was looking around to see if there were more hidden areas, but as far as I can see, there was only the two objects to find. The spare key, which I think is on the left side over there, and then... unless I get them mixed up. And Doll Knight Volume 7, I believe. Is that the last one I found? Yeah. Volume 7. Yeah. So just those two. I thought there was a third for some reason. So let's go see the Viscount and tell him the Duke wants nothing to do with him or his letters. How sad. The butler says, "Welcome. Have you delivered the master's letter?" McBain says, "Well, we sort of ran into a problem. May we see the Viscount?" "But yes, of course. This way, please." Una says, "Hello, Viscount Igul. How's your wound?"
"It's healing very well, thank you. What happened? I thought you headed for Envorin."
"We got there, but came back," says Forte. McBain told Igul about what had happened in front of Castle Envorin.
"I see. I'm sorry to have given you an unpleasant experience."
McBain says, "As for the letter you entrusted us with, we brought it back because we thought the Duke wouldn't read it." "We know that for sure after that incident. So we are returning it to you. Sorry we couldn't help." He returned the letter to the Duke.
"You don't have to apologize. We are old friends, the Duke of Pensola and I. When we were young, he and I played together in the mud. At school, we talked passionately about the future. I don't know what happened."
Butler says, "The Viscount was helping the Duke of Pensola as his assistant. The Duke loved the Viscount like his elder brother and often asked for his opinion. But recently, he's been pandering to the ideas of Merchant Rish. Only thinks about his short-term gain. The Viscount is grieving about it."
"We hear bad things about Rish. If nothing is done, Rish will squeeze all money out of the Principality of Pensola."
McBain says, "As you said, the Duke of Pensola looked like he was possessed by an evil." I don't remember him saying that. "I'm afraid the Viscount's fear is warranted."
"He wouldn't listen to my warnings now. I hope he has a good idea and is doing this for the good of the country. Although we had a difference of opinion and parted our ways, I still want to believe in him. He'll come around one day."
"We assume the Duke of Pensola is also attending the party in Riotam Island." Man, when are we going to get to this party?
"He's the one in charge of the preparation.
I don't know if we'll be able to help you in any way, but we'll go to Riotam Island ourselves." "Really?" says Forte. "They won't let us in the castle. We must find a chance to talk to the Duke of Pensola when he's on Riotam Island."
"Thank you, McBain. Now that you offered, could you please deliver this for me this time?"
Forte and his friends receive a velvet bag. How many things are we supposed to deliver for you? "What's inside?" says Forte. "They're making noise."
"You can look."
Forte opens the bag. He found shining glass marbles of different colors. Just marbles?
"Yes, they're just ordinary marbles. You must have played with them when you were young."
"Yeah." Una says, "Do they have any sentimental value to you?"
"Yes, from our childhood. If the Duke doesn't change after seeing the marbles, the Principality of Pensola is doomed. I shall then stand up for the people."
"I see," says McBain. "They must really mean something. We'll do our best to catch the Duke before he gets to Riotam Island." Wait, I thought that we were going to catch the Duke on Riotam Island. That was before? "We don't want to make you a revolutionary."
"Once the Duke of Pensola wakes up from this bad dream, I will protect the Duke with my life. I will do the best I can to make the Principality of Pensola a better country."
"We won't fail this time," says Forte.
"I'm counting on you." When the Duke was young, he had the big heart to admit his mistakes. I hope he still does.
I was waiting for the music to start back up.
I ask you myself, please help the master.
We will help your master, but it comes at a price. Your eternal soul.
What's our plan, Grandpa?
We'll enter the castle in Envorin first.
Una says we must think of ways to make the Duke see us.
What are our options, says Forte.
I already have a plan, McBain says.
What?
It's easy. We'll do what we do best. The question is how to get his attention.
Do you remember what the attendant said?
The Duke of Pensola is also looking for performers he can nominate for the audition.
In a nutshell, we just have to give our best performance, and I'm sure the Duke will come asking us to accept the nomination.
Will it really work as you said, says Forte?
If you think it will.
Let's go back to Envorin.
Yay.
We don't have to walk back. Grandpa, let's start our performance.
Hold on. We troubadours have our own rule.
Oh, so we're just going to perform out here and hope he comes out?
Now that Xiao made a blunder with his show here, we can't perform at this place without his permission.
It's because he just played here or you made a mistake?
Right, says Una. We must pay respect for your fellow artists.
Forte says we must find Xiao and Rachel then. Where have they gone?
McBain says let's ask Altos if he has seen them.
Anything else to say for these people?
Oh.
Something about her packing. Slowly came clear to me. People who can't pack quickly are not organized and lacking in decision-making ability. That's exactly the kind of person my sister is.
So they say different things.
I've been packing forever and I can't seem to finish it.
Oh no, I'm in trouble.
Anyway, women take a long time to pack. It's in our nature. But I really must finish packing, otherwise I can't leave. I'm such a troublemaker.
You think you're a troublemaker?
He doesn't seem to think very much of his sister.
Alright, so we'll go run around and talk to everybody and then talk to the bread maker.
The Troubadour Company?
Oh, those artists who were hired by the bakery. I haven't seen them here. Try the bakery. They may be there.
Oh, the musical group of the accordionist? No, I don't think they are here.
What? You're looking for the sexy lady and her friend? I haven't seen them around here. If they're staying at this inn, I would certainly want to make friends with them myself. Or, well, with one of them.
Alright. Who else wants to speak?
Forte, we can't go to Muth just yet, Una says.
You're right, says Forte. Same thing.
Yeah, they don't say anything new.
The quality of troubadours is not good these days. Their skills aren't that bad, but they don't perform seriously.
Oh, yes. That's the same thing.
We'll perform, but not specifically for you.
I think that's the last one. Yeah. Let's see what that soldier might say. Same thing. As Vish's party draws near, I feel that the entire country of Pensola is losing its calm. It's not my home country, but I'm worried. I think that's actually what he said before. Let me out! So I think we've talked, everybody. Oh, not these two. My child is a little disappointed. I hope other performers will come and entertain my child. Your child has a name. The fat man is gone. I guess the audience didn't like him, but that was the best part of their performance. Let's go, see if we can find them. Forte says, hello. We're back, says Una. Alto says, hi there. How is Viscount Eagle? He was fine, says Una. His wound had healed quite well. That's good. Actually, we have a bit of trouble. What happened, says Forte. Xiao and Rachel terminated the contract for the promotional performance and left. Edgar says, they said that there was some urgent development, and that they had to enter the audition on Vietnam Island. What? Says McBain. How could he leave in the middle of a contract? When I see them again, I must smack them real hard. Violence. Grandpa, then we should take over from Xiao and do the promotional performance ourselves. Yes, it's perfect, says Una. What do you mean it's perfect? Alto says. McBain says, we wanted to perform in Envorin anyway. We were looking for Xiao and Rachel so that we can get their permission to perform. Without their permission, we can't perform in the same place where their show failed. I know Xiao. He must have taken the advance money with him, right? Edgar says, as a matter of fact, yes. You must know him really well. Allow us to make up for the unprofessional conduct of our fellow artists. We are sorry for the trouble they caused you. We'll do the promotional performance. Of course, we won't charge you anything. Don't worry about Xiao, says Edgar. McBain says, no, we must do this. Grandpa, you're so cool. Edgar says, now that you offered, I would love to have you do the performance. Oh, wait a minute. A special bread for us? Forte received a bread bag. They smell really good, says Una. Please take them for use in your promotion. McBain says, in fact, they will help us a great deal. First, we give out bread to people in town. After that, we give them our performance. That's a good idea, says Altos. I'm sure many people will turn up. Forte, professional performances are one of the jobs we do as troubadours, says McBain. Why don't you take the lead? But what should we do? First, we give out bread to people in town and tell them about our performance. When we have given out enough bread, we start our performance in front of the fountain. That's the rough plan, but you'll decide on the details. Is this a part of our training as troubadours? That's right. Do you think you can handle it? Yes. I'll do my best. Edgar says, very well. Good luck, then. Well, Altos, we must get to work. Let's bake a lot of bread before customers come in. Yes. All right, Forte, Una, we should get to work, too. I look forward to the performance. My voice cracking. I think giving many people free bread itself will be an effective promotion. McBain says, this is part of your training. After you have given out enough bread, start the performance in front of the fountain. Yes, Don't worry, Grandpa. Alright, let's look at... I forgot to look at the other item, too. So, items... Bread bag, yeah. Give away breads made by Edgar's Bakery. Given away to customers, so don't eat them. Velvet bag. Small bag filled with marbles. Has a sentimental value to Viscount and Duke. Okay. Now we start giving this stuff out. Yo, want some bread? Hi there, cute musicians. Una says, we came here to promote the bakery. Have some. Una handed out a piece of bread. Oh, the bakery's finally opening again? That's fantastic. I don't have to rack my brains about the menu. Wait a second. You attended the promotional performance by Xiao and Rachel, saying, go to the bread shop's open, and now you're surprised that the bread shop is open. Okay. Forte says, we'll be performing at the Fountain Plaza. If you're interested, please come and listen to us. My child loved performances. I should go myself, too. Speaking of your child... What is it? Una says, here, have this bread. It's fresh out of oven. Una handed out a piece of bread. Thanks. Munch, munch. Wow, it's so yummy. Forte says, we'll be... said that before. Sure, we'll come and listen to your performance. I think there's going to be a bit of, like, repeat dialogue, so... I still want to read the same thing over and over. My sister finally finished packing. You look exhausted, says Forte. Have some of this, says Una. Una handed out a piece of bread. Oh, thank you. Yep. Right, I may be able to go after my sister leaves. Munch, munch. This bread is tasty. It's delicious. Now I can leave. Una says, we're making rounds promoting the bakery. Please buy from Edgar's Bakery. Here, have some. Oh, thank you. Which bag should I put it in? If I open that one, those things will come out. If I put the bread here, it'll be crushed. Oh well. How about you jam it in your mouth and you can just chew it as you walk? Oops, I must go. Forte says his thing, I'm sorry, but we must catch the ferry from Muth. I'll eat the bread on the boat. Let me see. Did I leave anything behind? Huh. I wonder how many pieces of bread. Are we going to run out? That we gave her the bread? And someone else doesn't get a piece of bread? So it's not optimal, you know what I mean? What's this smell? Come to Edgar's Bakery, says Una. Well, they delivered flour, and he could open the store again. Now that Edgar got serious, we must work hard to compete. Oh, Forte didn't say his little spiel. Yes? McBain says, please come to Edgar's Bakery. Would you like some? Oh, thank you. It's so savory. The taste hasn't dropped at all. Forte's bit. Well, that sounds fun. The Fountain Plaza, right? I'll certainly come. Hey, what's going on? Anything fun? We came to promote the bakery, says Una. Here, have some. Well, well, it sure looks delicious. Munching away. How delicious. It's tasty, isn't it? Forte thing. It does sound fun. You'll be performing at the Fountain Plaza, right? I look forward to it. Well, we can't talk to her about the bread. She doesn't have an exclamation mark. Unfortunately, the hotel receptionist, I guess? They're practically robots. Kick! What are you doing? We came here to promote the bakery, says Una.
Here, have some. Munch, munch. Wow, it's yummy. This bread is yummy. I want to give it to my dad.
I've reminded you of your dad again.
Well, is something going on? Bread from Edgar's Bakery, Serena says. My daughter and I love that bread. Thank you. We'll eat it later. No, she's eating it now. A performance at the Fountain Plaza? Alright, I promise I'll be there with my daughter.
Okay. Getting the. So we'll see if they say anything different.
Hi! May I help you?
We're here to promote Edgar's Bakery, says McMahon. If you need any bread, you can find it at Edgar's Bakery. We hope to receive your patronage. Una handed out a piece of bread.
I love the bread of that shop. Mmm, it smells so good.
We'll be performing at the Fountain Plaza, says Una. If you're interested, please come and listen to us.
I don't want to see a disaster again.
We're different from those guys, says McMahon.
Well, well. You're so confident.
Wow, what's going on? We're promoting the bakery, says Una. Have some bread, here. I hope you'll buy from Edgar's Bakery.
Thank you.
Munch, munch.
Yummy.
Forte's thing, I will.
I can't wait to see you, listen to you perform.
And see you perform.
Oh, are you troubadours? Yes, we are, says Forte. We're promoting Edgar's Bakery now. Here, have some, says Una.
Oh, thank you.
The bread looks delicious. I haven't eaten bread for a long time.
Mmm, it's crispy. This is the taste of Edgar's Bakery.
The bakery went almost broke because of the irresponsible governance of the Duke. I'm glad it's open for business again.
Indeed, sir, indeed. Does this guard want some?
Oh, you people again. Forte says, this time we're not here to see the Duke. Una says, we came here to promote the bakery. Would you like some?
Gatekeeper munching away.
It's heavenly delicious. Of course, the bread is fresh out of the oven.
Thank you for inviting me, but I'm a gatekeeper. I can't leave the gate.
Well, I'm sorry for the last time. I chased you away with the other guys.
Don't worry, says Forte. It's your job as a gatekeeper.
Thank you for your understanding.
I can't leave my post, but I'll certainly listen to your performance from here.
That might be everybody, because we can't give it to the merchants.
Oh, him.
May I help you? Please come to Edgar's Bakery, says Una.
The bread very soft and slightly sweet. Isn't it delicious? It's fresh out of oven.
Forte's spiel. Oh, he doesn't even answer him.
I remember this taste. I had it somewhere before.
Where did I eat it?
Forte says, was it at Brazil and Graysel? A baker from Brazil is now helping at the bakery.
Oh, really? All the way from Graysel?
No, I haven't been to Brazil before.
Oh, I remember. This is the taste of the bread I had in a bakery in Cavaro. The bread of Edgar's Bakery tastes heavenly. I'll certainly become a patron.
This is such a small town, how could anyone who lives here not be a patron some way?
You must be having fun. We came to promote the bakery, Una says. Would you like some?
Really? Thanks.
Munching away. This is so tasty.
Bread is fresh out of oven. I'm sure the bread will taste as good after some time.
Thank you. So this is from Edgar's Bakery. I'll come to your store and buy some bread.
Well, it's not our store, but thanks.
Thanks, dude.
Is that everybody? I think we talked to everybody.
And this isn't a town where you have people wandering around outside. They're all in buildings.
Some of them move around inside the building, but they don't come out.
Alright, let's go back to the bread shop.
Yeah, we can't give it to them.
McBain says, it's perfect. It looks like everyone in town got a piece of bread.
Oh, I was heading back for the bakery, I didn't know.
Our bread bags are empty now, says Una. You did well, Forte.
What was...
Una did most of the talking, it seems. The main event is about to begin. Let's start our performance. We'll walk around the fountain, playing our instruments.
Listen carefully. The key to a successful promotion is to get the people to have fun, rather than trying to perform well.
Forte, Una, have a blast yourselves so that people watching us will feel happy too.
Yes, they said.
Jan, Rick, we need your help too.
Ruff!
Let's begin the promotional performance of the McBain Company.
Well, I thought I get to choose the song. Yeah.
Let's dance.
Well, it doesn't sound like the David Bowie song.
Put on your red shoes and dance the blues? Or your red ribbon on a mouse? A rat?
Oh, who's that?
There's a little girl and her mother.
Haha! The dog does cute tricks.
McBain says, now, greetings to the people of Envorin. The McBain Company is here. As our colleagues had informed you earlier, Edgar's Bakery is now open for business after a period of closure.
Serena says, we can eat Edgar's tasty bread again.
We apologize for the great inconvenience we caused you during the closure.
We weren't even here.
To make up for your inconveniences, the McBain Company will be putting on a special performance.
Canuck says, the other artist said the same thing.
Are you sure you can perform?
Don't you worry. We'll promise we'll do our best to entertain you. First,
Happy Traveler.
Rig says, wow, it's cool.
Canuck says, yeah, I love it.
Thank you very much for your generous support.
The McBain Company show in Envorin ended in great success.
Grandpa, everything went great.
As we had planned, of course.
But Forte, don't forget the real purpose of that performance.
What?
What was the real purpose of that performance?
To promote the bakery, right?
This boy is hopeless, says McBain.
Una says it was to create a word-of-mouth effect, to draw the attention of the castle.
McBain says, unless the Duke of Pensola gets interested, our performance has failed.
Oh, yes, says Forte.
Let's see, I didn't even know.
Get a hold of yourself, all right, says McBain.
That we should tell...
Get a hold of himself. Now we should tell Edgar that the performance went well.
Well, I wonder what everyone else has to say about the performance. If they have anything to say.
They probably do.
People loved your performance. We can hire you ourselves if the regulars come back.
We envy Edgar's Bakery.
was a magnificent performance. Your music blew away the heavy air covering the entire country.
I don't think it did that.
Your performance was really awesome. One piece of advice I can give you is that you need a sexy woman.
What about Una?
Need a sexy woman, she says.
Una's looking disappointed.
Oh, it's only a joke. You were pretty enough to draw the crowd's attention.
Your piccolo was lovely too.
It's too late to offer compliments, says Una.
I'm afraid you got on Una's bad side.
And that's not easy to do, I don't think.
Loser.
Your performance was really good.
Thank you, says Una.
I wish my dad were there. My daughter is so happy after listening to your performance. I'm glad I brought her with me.
You were not bad at all. You showed us the true spirit of the professional artists we used to have around here. I thought we couldn't find troubadours like you anymore. I'm so glad.
You were so cool.
Okay, that's short but sweet. Okay.
It was a brilliant performance. I haven't felt this good in a while. I feel my mind was enriched. I wish the Duke were there for the performance. If he listens to a great piece of music, he may change his mind. He may think of his people more.
Maybe.
I heard your performance loud and clear. It was a really great performance.
Sister finally left, huh?
You were great. I've never heard anything like that before.
My sister has left. Finally left for Muth, and I'm relieved.
You're so talented. I was moved.
Una laughs and says, thank you.
But I would also love to see the comedy the other guys played again.
Maybe we should do some comedy bits.
Do some stand-up.
You guys were great. I like the fat man better, though. He was strange and funny.
Forte says only he can do that.
The fat man, where is he?
They left. He abandoned you in your time of need. I'm gonna talk to them last. I don't know if there's anyone else to talk to. Actually, yeah, this guy.
Were you the musicians who gave that exquisite performance just now? You were as good as the performance from Cavaro.
Why, thank you.
People are raving about your performance. Good luck to you on your tour of Marcheros.
Oops.
This is a whole big place with other people in it.
I'm really mad that you're not letting us in.
I've killed people for far less. McBain says, "How's your bread sales?" "Good work. Thanks to you, the bread sold really fast." Alto says, "Everyone was talking about you. They said that the performance of the McBain company was the best." Forte says, "Receiving such a high compliment from you, Altos, I'm kind of flattered." "He didn't say that. It said the people said that." "Our reputation has just gone up through the roof," says Edgar. "Thank you very much." "We can't give you much, but please accept this as a token of our appreciation. I guess bread?" McBain says, "Thank you, but we did what we had to do to cover for the blunder of Shao and Rachel." "No, I insist. Thanks to you, we sold much more bread than we had expected. The business is doing very well. It would be wrong not to offer you something." "Uncle truly appreciates what you have done. Please take the money." "In that case," says McBain, "we gratefully accept your gratitude." So we have gratitude for his gratitude. Nice. Forte and his friends receive 1,000 gems. Una says, "Do you think Shao and Rachel have already arrived at Ryotam Island?" "I don't know," says Edgar. "Because many guests were invited to the party, the ferry terminal is always crowded these days. Other passengers are refused a seat on the ferry. Passengers coming back from the port of Muth were complaining." McBain says, "It's a vicious cycle everywhere." Alto says, "The port of Muth is a tiny port. Other than the pier, they have nothing. It's a boring place to wait for the ferry." Una says, "People waiting for the ferry may not be able to have decent meals." "That's right," says Altos. "Hey, Uncle Edgar, why don't we deliver bread to them? I'm sure they will enjoy our bread." "That's a good idea. People will certainly love it." "But it will take some time to bake bread," says Altos, "for so many people." "Shall we help you?" says Una. "No, no," says Edgar. "We can't receive any more help from you." McBain says, "Then why don't we go there and check out the situation? We want to know how crowded the port is. If the castle does send for us, I can argue our case better if I have seen what's going on with my own eyes." "I know Grandpa is up to something." "It's not a big deal," says McBain. "Thank you then," says Edgar. Alto says, "Watch out for monsters on the road." I thought we were taking a port ship. Altos has been helping me a lot. He's a skilled baker and does things quickly. Oh, good. Wow. Well, I'm so motivated. I'll bake delicious bread. Okay. You will bake delicious bread. Anything else new to say? I'll just check these two and then I'll... So, are we supposed to talk to the Duke, or what? Or are we supposed to head for the... What do you call it? Where are we? Oh. I guess we're heading to... Moose. This Duke really plays hard to get. Okay, next episode, guys. Heading to Moose. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.